you are exiles. We are the exiles. We are the fallen.
You made the decision to go after Strange Flesh. This is about one thing. This is about us being consumed by another race. Let's get them in a host body system so we can destroy them. You're a kingdom divided. You're good and evil. You are the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. To rectify that situation, you got to be turned up. That's how you know Jesus. And if it doesn't add up to the scriptures, then it's not true.
Strange with Nancy Pelosi. You'll remember at the State of the Union address the other day, she sat behind Joe Biden, and at one point, she was so ecstatic and so keen to do standing ovations, although she's not very good at them, I'm afraid, poor thing, as she gets older. At one point, she threw herself up so fast she almost fell over the podium and had to sort of steady herself. And then there was she did this weird knuckle rubbing like a girl on Christmas morning about to get presents. And she did this and got up and grinned manically. And Joe Biden was talking about burn pits. And she didn't at all stop the old knuckle rubbing happy girl on Christmas morning thing. She just sat down still rubbing away.
For demonstration, kids. Here it goes.
Oh my God. Have you ever heard of insect politics?
I'm not just talking about sex and penetration. I'm talking about penetration beyond the veil of the flesh. A deep, penetrating dive into the plasma pool. I'm not just talking about sex and penetration. I'm talking about penetration beyond the veil of the flesh. I'm not just talking about sex and penetration. I'm talking about penetration beyond the veil of the flesh.
Have you ever heard of insect politics?
All right, folks, God bless you. Welcome to This Is It. This is it. 4, 3, 2, 1. Before the fire. Guys, so let me ask you a question. Have you guys ever heard of insect politics? Got some stuff to show you. You might not even believe, but that's what you get when you come to this channel, right? Why do you think the largest altar in the world is an insect harvesting angels? So here's the insect, and it's harvesting angels in the form of a dead sheep. Find that kind of strange, don't you? What about the list of popes in the Vatican, which is right here on your screen? The list of popes, right here. I wonder why the list of popes has a guy in a slave collar that, when you turn it upside down, becomes an insect coming out of the ground. Well, what's in the pit? Locusts that come out of the pit. So here's a guy in a slave collar, but he becomes an insect. Let me ask you an honest question. Do you believe that this image right in front of you right here that I'm showing you right here right now, do you believe that's the head of an insect? Do you believe that the Vatican that I'm showing you right here is the head of an insect? Let me put this one on top of this one. So do you believe that this right here is the head of an insect? the same as the Vatican? It's a yes or no answer. If that's an insect, then insect politics is all there really is. Because that's the Capitol building. You know, the Lord gave me this very special ability to see that in artwork, what you think you're looking at is hardly ever what you think you're looking at. That's been made manifest by 70,000 images that are in folders. I think Dave did the math, and I think I have over 70,000 images. And a good percentage of those images are the same thing you're seeing right here, whether or not it's an image of the Virgin. When you turn it upside down, it's a dead sheep. Do you believe that when I turn an image of the Virgin upside down that I've shown you 1,000 times, do you believe that's a dead sheep? And if so, why is it a dead sheep? Let me ask you a question. Is that an insect tattoo on this girl's chest? It's a yes or no. It's just a yes or no. Okay. Is that the head of an insect? It's a yes or no. For those of y'all that have seen the 2020 dating commercial, when Satan answers his phone in hell and it says, "You're a match," and he goes and meets this girl, is it insinuating that this girl is the insect that's his match? Well, the answer is, of course it is, because he goes and meets her. So everything's about females and insects. Have you noticed? Nancy Pelosi, when they're talking about burn pits, Nancy Pelosi's doing this number. I'm going to show you some stuff again today that's so beyond conclusive that to argue with this guy named Jonathan Kleck, you would have to be delusional now. There's too much evidence. The evidence proves it, and the Bible. I'm going to show you Bible scriptures today that once you see them, you're going to go, okay, this is absolute manifestation of the Word of God. So the gift that the Lord gave this guy, Jonathan Kleck, is what's called a confirming witness to the Word of God. It confirms the Word of God is true. That's what it is. That's what the whole ministry's been. And now I'm going to slam the door in Satan's face as hard as I can, because the time's here. The insect politics are taking over. The manifestation has gotten so ridiculous that if you can't see it, you are it. Today, the Lord had me walk into a clothing store, and I was confused, like, why are you having me go in here? And he told me to just have a look. And I just started sliding through the shirts. And how about if I just show them to you, and just instead of telling you about it? Do you know when you get people to laugh at something, if it's real, and even if it's like a reality that's a horrifying reality, if you can make people laugh at it like it's a joke and it's not real, do you know that takes that reality and it does something to your brain where your mind almost can't believe that's a reality because it's been made fun of as it's like, there's no way that's real. There's no way that could be real. Let me show you a couple of those, okay? Let's just get everybody in the right spot, because is the Vatican a snake? It's a yes or no. Before we laugh at it, let's watch an interview with that guy from 60 Minutes. I think it was 60 Minutes or 2020. And try to imagine that no one had ever shown you what this guy Jonathan Kleck showed you, that in Genesis 1, the name for God is Elohim. Elohim said, "Let us create man in our image." And the word image means a vain show, a representative figure, especially an idol, an illusion. So let us So Elohim said, let us create man in our illusion. Elohim said, let us create man in our vain show. That means a poser, like an actor, a fake. Elohim said, let us create man in our representative figure, especially an idol. So if an insect race was creating what you call man and woman as a host body system, that's really their image, because there's this Canadian coin that shows an insect looking at its reflection that's human, which would be exactly right if you believe Genesis 1 means Elohim said, let us create man in our illusion, representative figure, especially an idol. Isn't the host body an idol? It's a yes or no. Exodus 20 says it is. You shall not make unto you yourselves any graven image or any likeness of anything in the heavens, the earth, or the water under the earth. The word any likeness means embodiment. If you don't believe me, let me show it to you real quick. Any likeness. Something portioned that is fashioned out as a shape that is indefinitely, see the word phantom right there? Phantom. You know, in Genesis 1, when it says, Elohim said, let us create man in our image, the very first thing it says is to shade a phantom. Number one thing it says is to shade a phantom. In Genesis 1, Elohim said, let's create man in our selem, a phantom. Right here in Exodus 20, thou shalt not make unto thee any graven image or any likeness of anything that is in the heaven above, or that is in the earth beneath, or that is in the water under the earth. Wow, think about those words. What about the word likeness? Here it is, likeness. What does it say? Something portioned out that is fashioned out as a shape that is indefinitely a phantom, or specifically embodiment, figuratively manifestation or favor, image, likeness, or similitude. Okay. Now, let me ask you this. If some guy showed you that Genesis 1 was not the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, but it was actually Elohim, which is not the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Elohim was created by El, the Almighty God. So, if you had never seen someone show you the word image, which is Selem, who could ever come up with the idea that Elohim created man in their image as insects? So did you hear what I said? So who in the world could say, oh, you know, like they're under hypnosis and they could say, oh, we're Elohim. We created mankind. And then it turns into an insect thing. That's 1 in 100 trillion. It's not even possible. But you're about to see it right now because I have it. And I played it for you. But a lot of times people don't do the mental math. It's like, wait a minute. How does some guy under hypnosis get exactly right what this guy Jonathan Cleck said, who claims that he's a mouthpiece for the Lord? And he's manifesting a lot of really crazy supernatural things that other people don't manifest. And he said that Elohim somehow is associated with insects. And as it turns out, in the pit, the eternal abyss, I don't think anyone's ever mentioned that Satan is the king of the locusts, the insects from the pit. Has anyone ever heard that before, this guy, Jonathan Cleck? I'm just curious. I mean, when you thought of Satan, did you go, oh, he's the king of the locusts from the pit? Did anyone ever say that? Or did they just say he's some guy running around in a red suit with a pitchfork? I mean, which one is it? Well, I know what the Bible says. Revelation 9 says, Revelation 9, verse 11, they had a king over them, the angel of the bottomless pit, whose name is Abaddon, and Greek has the name Apollyon, which is Satan. And he's the king of who? The locusts from the pit that have hair like women, faces like men, teeth like lions, tails like scorpions, and the sound of their wings is like many horses rushing into battle. That Satan, the one that's actually described in the Bible with the exact words that match all these pictures this guy named Jonathan Cleck has in folders. It's kind of weird, right? No one ever talked about Satan being like this insect king, right? Y'all ever see a movie called The Scorpion King with The Rock? Here we go, ready? So the 2020 show claims that John is being interviewed under hypnosis and channels an alien that demon to speak through him. The interviewer asks John, "Who are you?" To which John replies, "Elohim, the original makers." Now I want to stop right there for 1 second. So some guy under hypnosis that doesn't know Jonathan Cleck actually said under hypnosis, as a demon is channeling through him, he says, "Who are you?" And he responds, "Elohim." Okay, sure. That's like, no, I'm serious. And no, you can't. There's no way. No, I'm totally serious. I'm trying to make a point. I'm being very facetious right now. "Who are you?" To which John replies, "Elohim." Wow. "The original makers. We are the makers of worlds. You are our children. We made you in our image. But there are differences." Do you know what you're looking at? Do you know how far impossible what you're looking at is? Now, start thinking about commercials, 2020 dating commercials, where Satan gets a text on his phone down in the pit and says, "You have a match," and it's a bug, and he goes and meets her for a date. Just stop and do the math. Look at what you're looking at. Stop and do it. Is that even possible? I'm serious. Is it even possible? Well, when it's true, it's not even that it's possible, it's probable. It's an eventuality, of course. Here you go, ready? "But there are differences, so let's watch and see what happens." And then, by the way, I have stuff in this folder, again, that y'all have never seen. You know why? Because the dam is broken. The floodgates are wide open. There's so much data, I can't contain it. It is off the charts. The end of the world's here. They're all about to be destroyed.
"Who are you?"
"Alien."
"Alien?"
"Elohim. We're the original makers. We're the maker of worlds. make worlds with love.
You made the people.
Yes, you are our children.
What do you look like?
You would find it hard to look upon my face.
Why?
They're different.
Pretty? Or not so pretty?
We think we are, but you probably would think not.
Well, let me pause that and let's just analyze that for a second. Well, so if Elohim started a human race that's really a puppet show, and they're an insect race from the pit, from another dimension. Well, everything this guy's saying is absolutely perfect. I wonder how he got it perfect, according to this other guy known named Jonathan Kleck. How'd he get it right? He's not watching my vids, I don't think.
We made you an hour image.
Oh, you're our children, but there are differences. You would find it hard to look upon my face. Okay, let's keep going. Let's go back just a little bit. Let's do it again.
Be different.
Pretty? Not so pretty.
You probably would think not. We made you in our image. But there are differences.
Who are you?
Elohim.
Alien.
Elohim. We're the original makers. We're the maker of worlds.
You made the people.
Yes, you're our children. We made you in our image. We made you in our image. Ready. A couple deep breaths. Let's start.
Okay, so now he's gone into a deeper trance. He's just taking him deeper. And he's like, now, what are the possibilities that he could actually say insects now? Out of everything he could say, that Elohim are related to being insects. And him and his brother, whoever the person is with him in his regression, are being observed by insects, which is what this other guy, Jonathan Kleck, has been telling you.
Okay, I'm going to ask you on a scale from 0 to 100%. What is that? I want you instantly. Okay, that's great. Okay, now just please indicate with the India motor controls on your hands whether you've reached that 80% stage, yes or no.
I'm going to
ask you to go back. So you're moving back there now. Okay, I want you to know. Are you there now? Okay, what is it you see, John?
I don't know. What is it? Where is it?
Okay, John, what is it you say?
Bugs.
Bugs? How big are these bugs, John?
Bigger than me.
Bigger than you. Okay. How old are you, John?
Okay, so let's stop there for a sec. Now he's been regressed, and these bugs are bigger than him. He's going to say how old he is right now. How old are you? So now imagine a bug bigger than him at whatever age he's going to say now. Let's go back.
Bigger than you. Okay. How old are you, John? 3 years old. Okay. You mentioned another name. Who is the other name you mentioned?
William.
William. Okay. Who is William?
My brother.
How old is William?
Four.
Is William with you now? Okay. And what's happening?
They're watching.
They're watching.
The watchers.
Ah, they come through the window. Ah, get me, William.
Now, I don't know about you guys, you know, but I'm pretty good at just observation, obviously. Do you think that in any way, shape, or form is fraudulent? Not 1% of my being is telling me it's fraudulent. How do you get it all right, according to this guy named Jonathan Clack? How do you get all of that right? His reaction would be right too, wouldn't it? Isn't that what a little kid would do? A 3-year-old that saw bugs, wouldn't he scream for help like that? I've had 4 kids. I've actually seen a really big horsefly attack one of my kids, and that's what he did too. It's exactly what he did. He freaked out, panicked, and was screaming for help. All right, now I'm going to show you guys a trailer for a movie called Smile, but then we're gonna go back to this insect thing because I've got stuff to show you've never seen. You need to see it. You need to see some clothing brands that I went and looked at today. You won't even believe it. It's right out of everything this guy Jonathan Clack's been telling you. I mean, it's not arguable because you're going to see clothing lines that are not clothing lines that you probably know. I didn't know them, but they're out now. And you need to see what's on them because it's what people are wearing on their bodies. Well, if you're an insect race called the serpent race, the clothing lines that you're about to see tonight, you're going to be like, wow, it makes total sense though. That's the thing about it. It's all going to make perfect sense. Wonder why Nancy Pelosi was doing this when they were talking about burn pits. Well, what do the insects in the bottomless pit do? They burn us as energy. That's what they use us for. I wonder why Nancy Pelosi got so excited about that when they were talking about it. I wonder why she was wearing a pearl necklace. I wonder why Nikki Haley's wearing a pearl necklace. I wonder why Fannie Willis, they're all wearing these pearl necklaces. I've noticed it. It's like, what the hell's going on? Why are all these women wearing all these pearl necklaces? I showed you the parable of the pearl, right? Okay. Let's watch this for a sec. By the way, one reason I want to show you this is because, you know, the bending of the bow thing I showed you? You're going to see it right in here in a way that's going to blow your mind. And some of the stuff that's happening to me in public is ramping up. And I've noticed the people that are doing things that are really messed up, they're looking at me like that. It's not a normal smile. It's kind of a psychotic, like, you don't know what we just did to you smile. It's getting really creepy. Okay, let's watch. Well, what do you notice about this? It starts upside down, which is kind of weird because Jonathan Kleck showed you that you're in a world that turned a bunch of angels upside down, which is us, and that's how they kill us. We basically are crucified upside down. Okay, let's watch this. Ready?
Mm-hmm. is Dr. Rose Cotter.
What do you want from me?
Why is it that everybody else who's seen it is dead and you're alive? I've seen it too.
Whoa. Now, I want to just draw your attention to that. Now, remember, this guy, Jonathan Kleck, that told you your eye is a dimensional trough and that there is a voyeurist and a serial killer named Satan that's looking through your eye because you're part of his hive because he owns the host body system. That's why you have to be bought back from El, the Almighty God, the God of heaven, that wants to buy his children back that got trapped in the host body, because not everyone belonged. By the way, you know, Jesus came to save his people. It's very specific. Most people don't notice that in the Bible. He came to save his people, it says. Also, to be a light to the Gentiles as well. But it's kind of interesting that he's got his own people, right? Okay, ready? I remember this scene called A Night Under the Stars, where this guy I know was telling everybody that one of your eyes goes to the pit to a worm, which is made biblically manifest by Job 25. How can a man born of a woman be made right with God, where the moon shineth not, and even the stars are not pure in his sight? Man that is a worm. Say it again. Man that is a worm. How about what Jesus said? If your eye offends you, and the word offend means to turn upside down. If your eye turns you upside down, then pluck it out. It's better to enter heaven with one eye than to be cast into hell, where the worm dieth not, and the fire is never quenched. What about Job, where it says, and the worm will feed sweetly on him, and he will no longer be remembered, and the worm will feed sweetly on him. What about Joel? I will restore to you the years the canker worm is eaten in the locust. So obviously there's a worm eating us, because the Bible says so. But they don't teach that to you in mainstream churches, do they? No, they don't, because I went to some big ones, and I presented the information. They told me to get the F out. Even when I showed them supernatural stuff. Why? Ready? So that's where that dimension goes, huh? That was a female, by the way.
You have it.
Smiling at me.
Carl?
But not a friendly smile.
Rose!
The worst smile I've ever seen.
I am not gonna keep running. I have to face it.
You see the half a bow right there, you know, kind of like the, reminds me of that song by the Smashing Pumpkins, Disarm You with a Smile, right? Let's go back just a little bit. Is her head upside down? You know, the other thing I noticed is all this insect stuff, tattoos on genitalia and stuff, it seems to be centered around women. Now, again, I don't want to hear the misogynist comments. I'm going back to the beginning of the world, the beginning of the system. Not if you're a girl and you have a girl's body or you're a guy, it makes zero difference. It's the system that was set up from the very beginning, from the original, you know, like Adidas original, which is Genesis. The original is what? Genesis 1. That's the natural body. I have a scripture in here for you tonight that is from 1 Corinthians 2 that says the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him. Did you know that the word natural means superhuman, angel, demon? Yeah, it does. Can you believe it? That's the root of the word. I was like, wow, surprise. Yes, it's in your folder. Okay, here we go. So that was pretty creepy, right? Now let me show you that trailer again. But let me show you the other one. Okay, now remember in Habakkuk, the Lord showed me the bottom half of the bow was discovering the female entity, the mother goddess, witch, prostitute, whore that sits on many waters. The prostitute that sits on many waters, the whore of Babylon, the twin female energy that runs the system. Her sins are piled as high as heaven. The time of her judgment has come. Hell hath enlarged herself beyond measure. It's all female energy. I don't want to hear any girls making a comment, oh, you hate women. Wrong. Totally wrong. I was given information that solves the entire mystery of the earth. What happens when you die? What's your identity, who we really are, and the Lord let me rip the veil down off the enemy's hiding place, which is in us. Body's just a shell. That's why the Statue of Liberty is on an 11-pointed star called a kelepot, an endecagram, which is a kelepot in Jewish Kabbalistic cosmology, and it means a shell, which is what my body is, a peel, which is what my body is, or a husk, which is what our bodies are. It's just, it's something to house energy. What does it house? The knowledge of good and evil. We are the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And the host body is the medium through which that battle is fought. And for those that took the bait of the forbidden fruit, see, you're guilty of original sin. So am I. We all are. Did you get a body? Well, then you're guilty. Why do you think you have to be redeemed? Why do you think you have to be redeemed in the flesh? Why do you think the Almighty God had to come into the system in the flesh to buy you back? Why didn't he just buy you back? Because, see, once you're in the flesh is owned by the pit. And if you don't pay up, then the pit gets your soul, your energy. So why? That's why the God of heaven came into that medium called the flesh and died on a cross in between two different guys representing your duality, the good you and the bad you, because you're the tree of the knowledge of good and evil. And he came into the middle to swap places with you because you are Barabbas. You know, Barabbas means son of the father, right? Isn't it crazy that in that prison that weekend was a guy named Bar-Abba, son of the father, and Jesus is Emmanuel with us as El, the son of the father. He's actually, he was born into the flesh as God's son in the flesh. That's crazy. It's 100% true. So if you don't take that gift, guess what happens to you? You suffer eternal damnation, which 1 second of it is unbearable. And here's the thing, it lasts forever. It never ends. It's eternal punishment. So that 1 second that sucks real bad, then try doing 10 seconds. And then try doing a minute. And then know that that lasts forever and it never ends. I'm just letting you know. Because you might want to turn back with your whole heart right now. Because I'm a harbinger. Yeah. Okay, so what makes you smile? Now remember, in Habakkuk, thy bow, the under half of the bow was made quite naked. That's what Jonathan Clegg's doing. I'm making her naked by exposing her, by inverting her. And when I invert her, I've made her naked so you can see her. Do you understand? It's the most obvious thing in the world now. That's why I wear this patch on my hat that says instructor upside down, because I'm showing you her world. All you have to do is invert everything. There you go. Look at the W right there. See the two intersecting Vs? There you go. Okay, ready? Let's do it. Look at her shirt. Her shirt is unbuttoned for a reason. See, the shirt is unbuttoned, and then what's behind it? You know, I don't see a lot of girls dressed like that, but, you know, she's got a little bit of the gang thing going, but kind of, but not really. And then she's got a T-shirt with a pack of tigers. There's a bar here in San Antonio called the Paper Tiger. Get it? Paper Tiger, because what's coming out ain't good. It's going to rip right through it. Here you go. Ready?
What is it you like to talk about?
I'm patient. Hi. I know you're nervous. I just want to have a chat.
I'm seeing something no one else can see except for me. It's smiling at me.
Yesterday, a patient.
Did you see that?
Yesterday, a patient in your care died brutally in front of you.
I need to find an explanation for what happened.
It's smiling at me. It's smiling at me.
You're going to die! You're going to die!
I found 20 cases involving 19 victims with a direct line linking them all together.
You said only 19. Why is it that everybody else who's seen it is dead and you're alive? I've seen it too.
You?
Get away from me!
How long between each victim's death?
None of them survived longer than a week.
Rose!
Today's my fourth day.
I am not gonna keep running.
I have to face it.
How does it make you feel?
I'm just really scared that something bad is going to happen.
There you go. Turn that frown upside down, huh? Yeah. Well, let me show you something, okay? Let me show you thy bow was made quite naked. Now, have y'all noticed that, well, the enemy, their color is blue, by the way. Adam, red. That's, Adam means red. Let me show you something real I find really, really fascinating. Remember the whole thing a little over 2 years ago, about around 2020. The future is female. Remember? There you go. The future is female. It's an entity. Female is an entity. Death is an entity. Life is an entity. Life and death are opposite entities. Female, twin female is death. Male is life. And that's made representative by the system itself. Even in your blood. Blood that's red has life in it. Blood that's blue doesn't. One has life, one doesn't. The system, one goes out, one goes in. Out and in. Everything's a microcosm of itself. Now, let me show you this. This is a new brand called Real Life, R-E-E-L, life. And on the front, it has a hook, like a U. It says, raised on the water. Now, do you think they're talking about you were raised on the water, like at the beach, and that's what the real life is all about? Or can you see past the veil like I can now? They were raised on the water representing our energy, our semen in the system. The other part of the equation, the one that had life in it, raised on the water. But watch this. So that's a little blurry, but that's the image of a snake making a duck, like a U one way and a U the other way. I think if I show it to you on this picture, you might be able to see the snake a little better. See right here? You see the snake? Okay. Let me show you this girl's tattoos just for a second. You see the bee right here? That bee? I want you to look at the back part of that bee. You know that's not what the back part of a bee looks like, right? If you put your hand over this part, it looks a whole lot like a penis, doesn't it? That being the head of the penis. And this being the shaft of the penis. But it's a bee, I guess. But I used to catch bees in jars when I was a kid. I used to look at them all the time. I'd catch them on flowers. I had a jar with a lid, and I would go and wait till they got on the flower. And I just go, boom, and then put the lid on it and sit there and check them out. I used to catch bumblebees, honeybees, all kinds of stuff. When I was a kid, I was all about catching snakes, scorpions, bees, cicadas. It was like I was a real outdoorsy little kind of kid, just all about it. I never saw a bee that had a torso like that. She's got this tattoo of a girl that's upside down with a book on her head. It's kind of interesting. It makes a V. You see it right there? But I'm more interested in her shirt. Let me tell you why I'm interested in her shirt. See, it's a girl, right? Yeah. Let me show you why I'm interested in her shirt. You see that guy standing in front of me? Well, you didn't know he was in front of me, I'm telling you. I went to go get a coffee this morning. That guy was in front of me. He was very obviously gay. I was able to determine that by the way he walked, the way he spoke, and his mannerisms. He was obviously gay. He had black fingernail polish on. And I looked at his shirt and I went, wow, burger, fries, and a snake. You know, like I'll have a burger, fries, and a shake. And I'm like, wow, check it out. He's got a shirt. It's burger, fries, and you see all these all the fries right here? It's got a snake on every one. It's burger, fries, and a snake. But what does the snake make up? See, you can find this on Etsy. It's female clothing, but these are guys wearing it. See, burger, fries, and a snake. What's the snake do? Oh, it's like Jonathan Kleck told us. It makes like one half and then the other half going the other way. You know? Like that rainbow thing he showed us. How in the world did he get that right? Well, I'll tell you how, because it's all true. You see the burger, the fries, and the snake? Well, let's look at his tattoos. Well, he's got a snake with its mouth open. He's got a big crocodile with its mouth open and its tongue hanging out. But the guy I saw wearing it, this guy looks pretty much soulless to me. He looks soulless. He doesn't look very soulful at all. But see, the guy in front of me was obviously gay, but he's wearing clothing that's from Etsy. That's a woman's shirt from Etsy, and it's burger, fries, and a snake. You get it? Because the serpent race is female energy. And they've taken over the entire freaking world now. See, they said that they really just wanted the right to get married, but they lied. So let's look at the Hendecagram again. Remember the top of the Hendecagram? You have these two yellow triangles that are facing up, representing the twin female system. And then you have these red arrows going this way, because this yellow triangle, one is going this direction and the other one's going this direction, representing like the blue and the red. And then they come back together at the bottom. But the thing that's being transmuted, this is called a transmutation circle. Okay, even though it, you know, it looks like a star, it's called a transmutation circle. But in the dead center of this right side up, upside down triangle is your essence in a five-pointed star. And at the end of the cycle, the star, which is in the twin system, becomes a one thing. And so that female system cannibalizes the male energy, and then you have these guys, Milli Vanilli, that were total posers. They were posers. They were a vain show. They were just total phonies is what they were. But there are two guys that are attractive in a feminine kind of way, and that's why they were used, showing that they represent, just like the end of the Hendecagram, where you get a male energy in the middle and you transmute it. And at the end of the cycle, see the two triangles that look like an M, like just like Milli, and then at the bottom, the V like Vanilli. See, Milli Vanilli are an exact representation of the transmutation circle that the Statue of Liberty is sitting on, because the Statue of Liberty represents the statue, your host body, that all the angels took the liberty of having a host body, and then they are transmuted into, from the two into one, and they've made the end of the cycle, and now they've been destroyed. So all the male energy is used up, so it's just feminine energy. Okay, and that feminine energy has cannibalized the entire system, which is the serpent eating its own tail. That's why there's burger, fries, and a snake, because the guy that's wearing the shirt is gay. You get it? It's like we've burgers, fries, and a snake, because they've eaten all the energy. And that's where we're at now in the system. And so it's easy to show you now because it manifests in everything. Now, y'all have heard about Psalm 23, yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. The valley of the shadow of death. Now, let me show you something. Let's go to Psalm 23 and let's look at that. Yea, though I walk, I know this word halak, it's to walk in a great variety of applications. A pace means to, like, you know, like pace, the word P-A-C-E, like what's your walking pace, behave self. Be conversant, depart, exercise, go forward, move forward. Though I walk, and it's because that energy from heaven, that male energy in a host body, though I walk through the valley, it says probably by transmutation from the same root as 1466. So it says a gorge from its lofty sides. Now, just quick interjection from Jonathan Clack. The Lord had me skydive into a gorge out in the desert called Chinati. I'll show you an image of it. It was a really serious landing to be able to make that. You better be a professional skydiver to make that jump. And I almost didn't make it. Came very close to missing it. It says a gorge from its lofty sides. It says exaltation, lifting up pride. The back, that is by extension, the body. Oh, wow. Though I walk through the valley, the body. Because, see, taking on the host body for the angels was pride. That's why it says in Ezekiel 28, thine heart is lifted up, and talks about Lucifer's pride. And Lucifer is the one that provided that host body, because he's the anointed cherub that covers, and it literally says to entwine like screen flesh. It says to entwine like screen flesh. Because thine heart is lifted up, and thou hast said, I am El. Nope, Here you go. See, it says right here, the person, the body, right there. Okay, though I walk through the valley of the shadow, so the valley, by extension, the body, of the shadow of death, the shade. Now, remember, Genesis 1, 26 and 27, the word Selem means to shade. And let me show you this. Death, concretely, the dead, the place, or the state of Hades, pestilence, ruin. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, the body, the word valley means, says a gorge, lifting up pride, and we see that in Ezekiel, says the back that is by extension, the body. Isn't it fascinating that the Hendecagram is back to back? Isn't it fascinating that when Ian Bud Light commercial, when he goes and gets made up by Minka Kelly, they make sure he puts on the new jacket and he's got a mirror behind him and he's back to back? Isn't it fascinating? They show that to you all the time. Like when they take him down the elevator in the Smirnoff commercial and they're showing you back to back. Isn't it wild that the elevator attendant, his reflection is facing the same way because he's the attendant to the elevator. He faces a different direction. There you go. Okay, anyway, through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. Bad as a noun, evil morally. Let's see if I highlighted any of this. I don't. Yep. To spoil. To be or to make to be bad. So the body, the shade of death, which makes you good for nothing, bad, to afflict and associate selves. Wow. You know what that reminds me of? Oh, that's what it reminds me of right there. The valley of the shadow of death. Have y'all ever listened to Sarah McLachlan? I used to like her music a lot. There's a song called Building a Mystery. You know, she hosts the Lilith Fair, honoring Lilith. You know, Lilith, the concubine, the succubus, the evil witch Lilith that was allegedly Adam's first, you know, intercourse, falling from grace by him touching Lilith. Isn't it fascinating that she hosts the Lilith Fair? And the song Building a Mystery, if you go watch it, how she's stealing the light out of the eye, literally shows her take the light out of the eye of the little girl. But what's fascinating is the lyrics in it when she says, "You're so beautiful, a beautiful fucked up man." That's what she says. And then she says, "Can you look out the window without your shadow getting in the way?" She says that before she says, "You're such a beautiful, beautiful effed up man." Yeah. She's a witch. Shadow of death. You get it? Y'all catching all this? You're starting to see all the common denominators? Remember, the future's female. What about the Burning Man? Remember the Burning Man party in the desert? Yeah, the big Burning Man. Here's a poster for Burning Man. There's Burning Man right there. There you go. Come on to Burning Man. Because your inversion is cooking. You got your body, though. Remember, you got your body. Let's talk about that Hendecagram coming full circle again. Because it's an insect race. So at the end of the Hendecagram, at the end, when Millie becomes Vanilli, when the Millies become Vanilli, the two become one. Let me show you the Mayan calendar. But before I show you the Mayan calendar, let me show you this picture real quick. You know what happened around 2020, right? There was this thing. A lot of people got stabbed with it. I just want to show you kind of a cool picture. You know, that's a bug's life right there. A bug's life. Kind of cool matchup. Just, you know, just matching things up. Let me show you the bottom of the Mayan calendar. You know, the way the two profiles come together and make an insect guy. So this is all one face, but isn't that crazy? It's an insect person. Now I know exactly what it is. It's an insect. The end of the Mayan calendar, the two coming together, you know, like the Hendecagram, the two coming together, the two profiles, when they come together, they make a bug. The Mayan calendar. That's crazy because I just got through reading about the Mayan twins and Quetzalcoatl, the feathered serpent. Isn't it crazy? There's a face on one side of the serpent's head looking one way and a face looking the other way. Just like this guy Jonathan Kleck's been telling you. Like one eye goes to heaven and one eye goes to the pit. You know, like one eye goes to the right, one eye goes to the left. You know, like the Jesus when he was crucified. There's one guy on the right, one guy on the left. Y'all know it's solved now, don't you? It's like, yeah. Oh, wow. So now everything's come together like in a way that is just not arguable. But now it's time to just kind of ask a couple more questions. Like, I wonder why in the world there would be a presidential portrait that portrayed the president as a T-Rex, but even more interesting, I thought, was the part where it portrayed him, he actually turned into an insect. Yeah. So the lines that went to the eyes of the serpent, they actually make antenna like an insect. And on his cheeks, there's real sharp lines that made mandibles of an insect. I just haven't shown it to y'all yet. Yeah, Obama becomes a big freaking bug. Isn't that crazy? Yep, he does. Insect politics. There you go. You did a wonderful job, Kahinde. Wonderful job. Where are the sperm? Oh, they're on your forehead on the right side, making a fang on the serpent. Oh, good. Glad you got that in there. Oh, I did show you this big bug during the pandemic. A big blue bug wears a face mask in support of frontline workers, and his name is Nibbles Woodaway. I did show you that it's an 11-pointed circle, right? Like an 11-pointed star. I did show you that in the middle of the 11-pointed star, like a Hendecagram, which represents, you know, your host body and the eye, that the all-seeing eye that the bug king looks out of from the bottomless pit. I did show you there's a 5-pointed star in the middle, right? Good. Just making sure. Just crossing the T's, dotting the I's, that kind of thing. Now, so do y'all remember the snake on the fries? You know, the burger fries and a snake, that shirt where the snake went like that, just made like that, right? Same as the thing that Kleck keeps showing you, like, you know, like the letter N and then the letter U just joined together down at the bottom, right? Yep. Do you see one right here? Do you notice? Let me enlarge that. Do you notice that it looks like that right here? You see this like shape right here? There's the house porch. But this sidewalk thing that's on stilts looks like the same thing, kind of, right? Now, it's time to have a little laugh. Y'all ready for a little chuckle? Okay, now remember, the Vatican is a bug harvesting semen. The Capitol building is a giant insect with another insect. And in the mandibles of that insect, Ulysses S. Grant. Ulysses means wrathful, and his beard becomes a dead sheep. And the only reason I know that is because the Lord God whom I serve told me as I was looking at it to go look in the mandibles of the bug. And I was like, look in the mandibles of the bug? Look in the mandibles of the bug. And I did. There was a statue. It was Ulysses S. Grant. And I heard the Lord tell me, turn the statue upside down, which is what those who try and hide their plans, they turn everything upside down. So I did what the Lord said, and there was a dead sheep right there. It was so obvious. I was like, oh my God, there's a dead sheep. Well, that's crazy. The Vatican is a bug with a dead sheep in his mouth. The Capitol building is a the building and the grounds. It's a giant bug with a dead sheep in its mouth. Downtown Grand Junction is a serpent strangling a sheep, which is exactly what the Vatican is a serpent eating a sheep, because the serpent race is really a bunch of insects that are hunting angels. That's why it's called the serpent race. The serpent, female energy. Okay, now, let's have a little laugh. Y'all ready? Now remember, you got to be careful, because when you laugh at something, you take away it's dangerous. So don't laugh too hard.
So this is where you two are going to stay. Like it?
Yeah, lovely.
Great. So what do you think of her?
What, you mean the blonde?
Yeah.
Well, she's attractive. She's very attractive.
Sir. She's 25 years old. Her skin is like a ribbon candy. Breasts like a sponge cake. Her calves are like calzone. I mean, highly edible. Highly edible. She's crazy about sex. You know, this is somebody to get me over the rough spot.
I'm going to pause it right there because I want you to watch something. I want you to look very closely right here. I want you to look very closely at whatever his name is. I want you to look at his tongue. Just now, remember, when you're filming something, you have cameras on that porch, and they know they're supposed to walk out there and then recite lines. They're called actors. Actors. They're pretending to be doing something. It's all pretend. So they're acting, and his line is to go out and respond to what Jeff Goldblum's saying and lean against the porch. But obviously he was told to stick his tongue out really far on the corner of his mouth and hold it. That's weird. Did you listen to what Jeff Goldblum is saying when he sticks his tongue out? He's talking about a girl being highly edible, and he's breaking down body parts and comparing them to like ribbon candy or a calzone. Highly edible. Highly edible. First of all, I find that really, really bizarre. Weird. It's not a way I've ever heard any of my friends talk about girls, and I've heard a lot. But I want you to look at this guy's tongue. Ready?
Highly edible. Highly edible. She's crazy about sex.
Sit. Why did he do that? Why in the world? Well, isn't the serpent race eating the sheep? Yes? Well, watch what happens to him. And then I'm going to show you a clip from Predator. Ready? Here you go.
Highly edible. She's crazy about sex. You know, this is somebody to get me over the rough spot.
You know what? I'm gonna see if I can get a better quality on this. I guess 480 is the best. Here we go. Here we go.
Tell me. What do you mean? What rough spots? Oh, Christine left me.
Christine means follower of Christ.
When? Oh, a week ago.
What happened?
Well, she wanted a child.
I'm sorry.
Okay?
Yep.
Okay?
What an idiot.
No, leave that.
There. Got it.
Jesus. Okay, here, take it.
She was, Christine wanted a baby.
Oh, she was hungry for seed. So I closed the iron door, denied her my essence. You know, I'm not ready to be biologically extraneous. She would have devoured me from the head down, you know, chewed up my manhood, swallowed my youth, and gobbled me up like some praying mantis. Not for me.
What do you mean, praying mantis?
You know, a female mantis, after she has sex with her mate, she eats him.
Oh, yeah. Oh. But Christine wasn't pregnant or anything like that.
No, I said, well, what do you mean, like on the sly or something?
On the sly or just, you know, in the run of things.
On the no. I mean, Christine has her faults, but I don't know who would do that. That's a knife in the back.
Yeah.
You know, that's certain. No, of course not. That's some voodoo woman who stays up at night and puts pins in her diaphragm.
Huh.
Spooky, Sam. Jesus. That's a she-snake. That's like the most hateful, cruel, sneaky, horrible thing you can do. Who would do that?
They eat the father!
Honey,
they eat him!
Honey, what, honey? Honey, what? Who eats fathers?
No one.
What?
Sorry. Just a bad dream. Okay. Silly dream.
Okay, you worry too much. Just relax. Lie down, okay? Lie down.
And now... Now it's time for dinner.
Dinner?
Samuel! Time to get up.
Daniel, time to get up. They're mocking the living crap out of us, you guys. They've been mocking us since the beginning, and now the Lord let me penetrate their entire system. The Vatican's a snake. It's a snake eating angels. It's a big bug eating angels. The serpent system is a female parthenogenic host body. You shall not make unto yourselves any embodiment, angels. Because if you do, that is the sin against God that destroys his children. Now do you understand what Jonathan Kleck's been showing you? Now let me show you some clothing lines. Y'all want to see some new clothing stuff going on at the shop store? Okay, so you guys have seen a burger, fries, and a snake. Oh, you know what? Well, wait a minute. We got to talk about, I'm sorry, but I've got to show you the Hendecagram one more time. Because the top of the Hendecagram is two triangles that are going opposite directions like this. And when they get to the bottom, you know what happens, right? The two come together as one, and the monster is let out of the cage, the pit. So when those two eyes make the circle, that's the cycle of an earth. It's full circle. Well, remember that trip I just got off. The Lord showed me we've come full circle. And now I can see it's manifesting in everything. I guarantee you it's into the world. It's not just what the Lord told me. He's already shown it and proved it now. Now watch. Now remember this, right? This. Now remember the whole getting naked and having sex thing in the beginning of the Bible? Willing to do that and take on a host body? And then... You have a. You were made naked. Why were they hiding from God now? Well, because they knew they had done the wrong thing, like we all did. We're all part of the original sin, all of us. So when you see this going opposite directions, you'll see it in a lot of stuff these days. That's the top of the Hendecagram, but at the bottom of the Hendecagram. Oh, not good, because that means they've come together, and the pit opens up, and what comes out of the pit is the monster, and that's it. Let me show you. We made a short little clip because we were going to show you the whole scene from this Predator movie where this female scientist is in a lab and they have a predator, and she's so excited because it's so cool, and she just thinks it's the coolest thing, and his DNA is like human as well, and she's like, oh my gosh, he's like part human. And yeah, she go find the scene. But we made a little 3-second clip out of it because we're not allowed to use it. It's heavily copyright stuff, but you can make a GIF out of it. So we made a GIF. Ready? Watch the GIF. Now, you remember at the end of the Hendecagram, which is, by the way, Satan's system. See, Satan is hovering above the Hendecagram because that's where he gets his energy. It's from the angels that get caught in the system. Okay, ready? Watch this. This is awesome. Let me show you an image real quick. I want you to look at how they did this. Look at her neck. See the triangles? They did this on purpose. Look how they framed that up. Go watch it yourself. She's in a decontamination. She's going through decontamination where you have to take off all your clothes. And the predator in the lab gets up, kills everybody. And she's huddling down in the corner in the decontamination area. And they made sure her collarbone and neck make the top of the Hendecagram. And then what happens at the end of the Hendecagram? I'll tell you what happens at the end. The monster comes out. And this is exactly what they have. Here it is. Look. There you go. Let that sink in for a minute. Let that sink in for just a minute. This is literally exactly what you see. No big deal. No. Let's look at some clothes now, huh? Okay, well, we saw burgers, fries, and a snake. Let's take a look at, we've got to cut. You know what? Let's do a couple of scriptures real quick. Matthew 12:11. This is where Jesus is talking to the Pharisees, and they're being pissy because he's going to heal a man on the Sabbath. But watch the deeper meaning to this. Ready? What man shall there be among you that shall have one sheep? This is all cryptic. Everything I just read. Man among you that shall have one sheep. It's referring to you. And if it shall fall into a pit. Look at the number for the pit. It's 999. But look what it says. On the Sabbath day, will he not lay hold on it and lift it out? Look at the word lift it out. Do the idea of collecting one's faculties to waken, to rouse, literally from sleep or from sitting or from death. Well, what happened at the beginning? The male energy was put to sleep, like Adam is Christ's representative, to stupefy with sleep or with death. Came down. We were down into the system. And then Eve came out of the side. Other direction, put in a system. So what sheep having falling down into a pit? If you look at the word pit, it says literally a cistern. Let's just go look it up. Matthew 12:12. Let's just look it up. Let's just spend some time together, guys. Matthew 12:12. I've already been through all this stuff, but I don't mind doing it again for you guys. Here you go. Watch this. I don't want to just try and get out of here quick. Ready? Okay, I won't break down all this. You guys can go do it. It'll blow your mind. Having one sheep, that if it fall into a pit, to be entrapped by. That's the word, fall into a pit. Okay, to be entrapped by. Into a pit, a hole, a pit, specifically a cistern. And it's from the root 900, from 901. It says to deepen as going down, from 939, to walk and pace about. So if you fell down into a pit, like all of us walking around here on the Sabbath, will he not lay hold, that is, use strength, that is, to seize or retain, like our Father, it and lift it out through the idea of collecting one's faculties to waken and to rouse from sleep or from death, to lift up, raise up again, rear up. That's us, guys. I mean, hello. We're the sheep. We fell, and he wakens, arouses us from death. To sleep, you know, arise, O sleeper, wake up from the dead. Now you know what that parable actually means. Praise God, right? Are y'all jumping around for joy? You should be, because the Lord God's made the Bible known to you now. This is what this is the actual true meaning of the word. Let's look at this one. 1 Corinthians 2:14. But the natural man receiveth not the things of the Spirit of God, for they are foolishness unto him. Neither can he hinosko them, know them absolutely, because they are spiritually discerned. So right here I drew these yellow lines to an angel demon. See it? The natural man. So let me go there real quick. 1 Corinthians 2. The natural man. Here we go. The natural man. Natural. It says from these root words. It says breath, implication, spirit. Abstractly or concretely, the animal sentient principle only, thus distinguished on the one hand from 4151. It's pneuma, breath, spirit, superhuman, superhuman, angel, demon, the natural man. Well, you know it's not God, Christ, Holy Spirit, because he's the natural man. And you really know it's not, you know, the other word, God, Christ, Holy Spirit, because that's what comes after it. The natural man, the superhuman angel demon man, receiveth not the things of the Spirit, capital Spirit. See it right there? Bam! Spirit of God. It's the same word, pneuma, but it's divine God, Christ, Spirit, because he's not regenerated. They're foolishness unto him, neither can he know them, to know absolutely. Hinosko, very important word. Because they are spiritually discerned, non-physically, that is, divinely discerned, anakrino, to vigorously scrutinize from down to up. You guys, y'all get it now? You know that the guy speaking to you, Jonathan Kleck, is the person that the Lord God would use to open the scroll that he unraveled. I didn't unroll it. He did. He used me as the point man. Not arguable now, is it? I got a whole bunch more scripture for you, too. And I'm going to go through it for sure. Watch this. Let's look at the clothing. We got to go through the clothing. Let's look at this one. Eros, bottle, whatever, New York scene, since 1987, okay? So just like burgers, fries, and a snake, the human race is turning into the full serpent now, because the female energy is taking over everything, because we've been associated with it so long, over such a long period of time, that towards the end of the cycle, it just takes over the whole host body system. That's why all the clothing is manifesting it. So it says, episteme, fitting on, which intensifies systeme, to stand properly, standing upon, referring to gaining knowledge by prolonged acquaintance, sustained personal effort. And it says, in relation to a believer, it's if you had long personal sustained fellowship with God, but they're doing the opposite, the exact opposite. To know and understand That's why all the clothing lines are manifesting what they are. Now watch. I'll just keep going. Watch. Watch this. Let me give you an example, right? Make it a super easy one. Let's do this one right. Hang on. Okay, you guys remember the rainbow thing, the right side up, upside down thing, right? There you go. Look at that shirt. Uh-huh. It's the same as the cross thing at the Vatican with the face with the three eye, you know, one face looking that way. There's three eyes, one in the middle. That's showing Satan's taking over both sides, you guys. Look at this. Look what you're looking at. Look. There it is. There it is. Look at the, what, a line right down the center of the shirt? Half this, half that? Well, you know, there's a tree of the knowledge of good and evil, right? They have it right there. Well, here's Vans. Let's look at Vans. Oh, wow. So it's, let's see, it's a barbed wire around the whole thing. It says off the wall. It's got a flame burning down, two trees that are barbed wired together with barbed wire that's like, you know, like that, opposite directions. I told you. Look, check it out. Look at that. Look at what you're looking at, you guys. Oh, we tied both trees together. By the way, remember that V thing? Everybody's standing in line to get that thing and their reflection was right side up, upside down? Told you. Yes. Same as the Ozzy Osbourne, patient number 9. Go watch patient number 9. Let's see. What about this one? RVCA, the balance of opposites. ESTMM1. Somebody look that one up. I'm sure it's good. Now, is that a fire down there? Or are those supposed to be leaves? Well, it looks... This tree doesn't look really healthy, does it? It looks like it's done, right? Like they burn. And let's see, what do you see? The V and the A doesn't have a line through it. The balance of opposites. And it looks like it's burning. If you close, you squint your eyes, it makes a face as well. These being the eyes right here. There you go. And so now this is just the common theme. Let's see, 96. Okay, Ghost Face 96. That'll be a strong thing right there for sure. So Ghost Face 96. So let's do a 96 on that. 96. From an unusual root meaning to flow down or together. Okay, that's one definition of it. Here you go. This'll be it right here. Failing to pass the test, unapproved. There you go. Adokimos. Let's see. Let's go have a look at that. Let's go have a look at that. Ghost Face 96. To flow down together. Well, it could be both of them, actually, because they both fit. Let's see the back of the shirt. There's the back of the shirt. There you go. Let's see. I saw this girl's... here's another one. Okay. Censored. Okay, well... It's a banana coming out of the peel. It's obviously phallic. But I think it was the brand that Vox Populi. That's from, you know where I remember that from? That's the speech for V for Vendetta when he saves Evie from getting raped and he does his little speech. The Vox Populi. Look at the X. It's like Extinction Rebellion, guys. Goat. I mean, it's just stupid. This is all the clothing, the greatest of all time. Yeah. But it's 88 is the brand. It's incessant without remission. And I've seen that on so many different clothing brands now. 88, incessant without remission. Because the entire history of the world, it's a nonstop process, incessant without remission, until they cleanse the sheep out of the system. That's what the whole earth is about, you guys. It's about serpents destroying sheep. That's it. Sheep are the angels. Serpents, the female energy. Mystery solved. And if you have eyes to see and you go look at like I did, and the Lord had me just like thumb through these shirts and to be able to see what it is, it's absurd. It's just absurd. There you go. Why is it a smiley face made up of all the different skulls? Well, I'll tell you why. Because no different than the trailer for Smile.
What is it you like to talk about?
Make sure you keep watching.
Hi. I know you're nervous. I just want to have a chat.
I'm seeing something no one else can see except for me. It's smiling at me. No! Oh my God!
Yesterday, a patient in your care died brutally in front of you.
I need to find an explanation for what happened.
You see the tree bending over on it? It's bending, it's turning.
It's smiling at me. It's smiling at me.
Take a look very closely at what you're looking at. You see down here? Red? You see that? Zero pain. It's blue and it's female. Look at it. It's blue and it's female and it's smiling. Do you know why? They want zero of us. Zero means a smile for them. No sheep, no pain. None of that. See, the red is the opposite of the blue. See it? See the frown down here? See the smile up here? Thy bow was made quite naked. She's a killer. You know, like the song by Queen, She's a Killer Queen. She's dynamite with a laser beam. That one? Queen? No pain. This is what they're going for right here. No more pain. That's why they zeroed in on it. Do you notice it's female? Okay, here it is. Without, apart from, oh my God. Oh my Lord, do you see it? They're in room 817. Apart from, without us, no pain. Get it? I told you. That's why it's a female. Look what you're looking at, you guys. Wait a minute. Look what you're looking at. Let's go right here. What is it? 817. Apart from without. I told you. Here it is. I was looking that one up on the fly. I just saw it. No pain. Look. No pain means without any of us. Zero. Watch. 817. Told you.
You're going to die. You're going to die.
Apart from without, they don't want their other good twin in them anymore. They just want to be what they are by nature. The originals. Told you. They're busting. Now would y'all like some scripture that'll make you feel really good? Let's get fast. Let's get past all this. Okay, let's do the scriptures now, you guys. Okay, you get what's going on? There you go. That's why they'll have a smile. Let's look at, okay, look at it. Look at the back of the shirt. You see the big circle like an eye? That's all, folks. And Daffy Duck's busting through the drum. Get it? Here it comes. That's all, folks. Members only. Lucky Lola Bunny. Right in front of your face the whole time they've been doing it. All right, let's look at some scriptures. Habakkuk, thy bow was made quite naked, to bend, to set a trap, to lay a snare. Told you. Right side up, upside down. There it is. Thy bow was made quite naked. Let's see. Here we go. You are my witnesses, saith the Lord. Mine servant whom I have chosen, that you may know and believe me and understand that I am he. Before me there was no God. Look at the word God. El, the Almighty God, formed. Yatsar. Neither shall there be after me. I, even I, am the Lord, and beside me there is no Savior. The self-existing eternal Jehovah. I have declared, and I have saved, and I have showed when there was no strange God among you. Therefore, you are my witnesses, saith the Lord, that I am El, the Almighty God. There it is. To front, stand boldly opposite. To manifest, specifically to expose. Okay? You are my witnesses. I'll do it for you right now. Sky, I know Jonathan Kleck. He said when you turn the virgin upside down, it's a dead sheep. Thy bow was made quite naked. You are my witnesses, declares the Lord. See, all the scriptures are behind me, aren't they? Told you. All glory to God, guys. All glory to the King. What you gonna do now, Satan? Oh, yeah, here you go. Woe unto them that seek deep to hide their counsel from the Lord, the self-existent eternal Jehovah. Their works are in the dark, and they say, who seeth us? Who knoweth us? Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay. Their works are in the darkness, as withholding light to darken, to be made dark. That's what happened in Genesis 1, to shade, to darken. Let's go to Habakkuk. Thy bow was made quite naked. We just saw that one. To set a trap, to lay a snare. Okay, let's see. 43:10. You are my witnesses, saith the Lord. Okay. Before me there was no God El formed. Okay. To duplicate. By implication, to protest, testify as reiteration. Intensively to encompass, to restore as a sort of reduplication. So, you are my witnesses, declares the Lord, to duplicate, to restore. If your eye be single, you've been duplicated. You got reduplicated. Your whole body's full of light. You know, Satan just hates this. Okay, Isaiah 43:11. There is no Savior. The word Savior is to be open, wide, free. The word is Yasha. By implication, to be safe, avenging, to deliver, to rescue, be safe, have salvation, get the victory. I, even I, am the self-existent eternal Jehovah, and beside me there is no Yasha. There it is. Okay, I'm just going to give you these scriptures now. We'll go to Jeremiah. It shall be when thou hast made an end of reading this book, that thou shalt bind a stone to it and cast it into the midst of the Euphrates. It's a river. And thou shalt say, thus shall Babylon sink and shall not rise from the evil that I will bring upon her. Her. Babylon means land of confusion. Babylon means a mixed race. And Babylon is her. Her. Told you. Again, there it is. Right there, her. That I will bring upon her. And they shall be weary. And thus far are the words of Jeremiah. Jeremiah 51:64. So Babylon is female, her. The woman that rides the beast. Are y'all starting to figure it out? Let's take a look at that girl from the band, The Warning. 01100110. And she says, the next set binary code in eight digits. It's F-R-E-E, free. So when that girl's singing that song, that's Satan saying, I'm free from the pit, singing through that girl. It's exactly what it is. Warning. Let's talk about this guy. And in the Hadith, it says, in the coming of the Mahdi, which is the one that will lead the Islamic world jihad, which is going on right now, it's begun. The guy that would lead that would be preceded by the sun rising from the place of its setting. Go watch my other videos I did about Lahaina. It's all proven. So that logo right there is exactly what the Hadith says. The sun rising over the west. Those are the stripes of the American flag, which is the west. That's the sun rising. Well, let's look at Joe O'Biden. That's the sun fully risen over 1, 2, 3 stripes. You know why it's number 3? Angel of the bottomless pit. See, I understand their symbology and how they work now. That's the serpent saying, I'm out of the pit. That's the Antichrist saying, I've risen out of the pit. Who do you think's pulling all the strings all over the U.S. that's becoming completely lawless? Isn't the Antichrist called the lawless one? The Renegade? Isn't that Obama's, what they called his car, the Renegade? Oh, that's what his code name was by the FBI guy that said they knew a decade before he even came up that he was going to be put in. He knew a decade before the FBI did. He's called the Renegade. Why do you think they protect it? Look, there it is. There it is. Can't argue with that. That's the sun rising over the west. That's the sun fully risen. That's O'Biden's logo. Can't argue with it. There it is. It's here, guys. I mean, it's here. There it is. Let's see. Got some more scriptures for you. Let's see if I can get down here. Let's see. Oh, here's a great one. Look at the Mickey Mouse. Come on, dude. Really? Mickey Mouse. Look at that. One right side up, one upside down, and a dimension. No way. Oh, wow. That was a shirt that some actor was wearing it. Let's see. I think maybe the stars got added. Let's see. Cast out. Oh, here you go. Ready, freak out, guys. Okay, Isaiah 14. Is this the man that made the earth to tremble, that did shake kingdoms, that made the world a wilderness and destroyed the cities thereof, that opened not the house of the prisoners? All the kings of all of the nations, even all of them, lie in glory, everyone in his own house. But thou art cast out of thy grave like an abominable branch, and as the raiment of those that are slain, thrust through with the sword, raiment, a garment literally, by implication, euphemistically, a wife. Talking about Lucifer. Do y'all understand what y'all are getting to see here? I mean, y'all understand what you're looking at, don't you? The Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he has anointed me to preach good tidings to the meek. He has sent me to bind up the brokenhearted, to proclaim liberty to the captives, and the opening of prison to them that are bound, to open the senses, especially the eyes. And it means to redouble your eyes. And I will go there right now. 61 verse 1, Isaiah. Very important verse. Isaiah 61. The opening of prison. Ready? The redoubling. Redoubled. Read it for yourself. Redoubled. That figuratively, salvation from sin. So, can anyone argue with Jonathan Kleck anymore? Your redoubling of your eye proves your salvation from sin. How did my eye get? Well, I turned the virgin upside down because the Lord God whom I serve told me to. And when I turned it upside down, it led me to the mystery of all of the stuff. Because neither shall you touch it lest you die. That was a trap set by Elohim for the angels. And if you took the bait, then you're in the trap. Okay. Now, since we're talking about the princes of El, you're my witnesses. It means to redouble. You're my witnesses, declares the Lord, to redouble. Okay, so we're his princes, and we're the ones that are from heaven, from God's inner circle, but we got trapped in this system called the flesh. Now I can explain to you or show you. That's why the Lord God sent me to Trinity. Here it is. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, there I am skydiving into a gorge. There it is. Which, what does the valley of the shadow of death say? A gorge. I skydive into there on the way to set up my LZ, which is right there. And there it is. You see the hundreds of trillions of rocks? I walked an entire mile down this gorge. And the Lord told me, pick up those two rocks, to which I did. And they were two halves of the same very thin rock. Look at that. Then he told me, put them together to redouble them and put them together and take a picture of them in the dead center of an X. Now, let me tell you something. Nobody could make that up. And it's all biblical. Now you know it's all true. There's the proof. I did exactly what he said. I went and caught my plane. When I went to catch my plane, a flash flood came in and flooded that whole thing. They said water was going through the whole thing. They thought I was going to die. But by the time I jumped, the water had dissipated. I landed about 20 yards before the target in the riverbed. And so when I went back and took my parachute back to my little cabin and I came back, this is what was waiting for me. So I had already put the rock there and got my picture. And then when I came back, where's my LZ? Oh my gosh. I thought I had a picture of the dirty LZ. Hang on one sec. So yeah, there you go. Here's proof. I left here to go catch my plane. I made my jump, carried my stuff back to my cabin. I came back, and that's what my LZ looked like. And there's a clear running stream on the side that's clean. And then I went back and I took a picture of my Bible that was open. And here's what my Bible was open to. For he himself is our peace, who has made both one and has broken down the middle wall of separation, having abolished in his flesh the enmity, the law and commandments contained in ordinances, so to create one new man from the two, thus making in himself one new man from the two, thus making peace, and having reconciled both to God in one body through the cross, destroying the enmity. He came and preached peace to you that were afar off and those who were near. For through him we have access by one Spirit to the Father. And I opened the, he told me, just open the Bible. And I opened to Isaiah 25. So now I'm going to let Max McLean read Isaiah 25 to you. And I would listen very closely if I were you. Okay, here we go. Now, I can honestly tell you, I couldn't tell you Isaiah 25 off the top of my head, and it's been so long since the jump, and my eyes are just on fire right now. But I'm going to let Max McLean read it, because I just know in my spirit right now that the Lord is going to give us a heads up. I guarantee it. Here we go.
Isaiah 25. O Lord, thou art my God. I will exalt thee. I will praise thy name. For thou hast done wonderful things. Thy counsels of old are faithfulness and truth. For thou hast made of a city an heap, of a defensed city a ruin, a palace of strangers to be no city. It shall never be built. Therefore shall the strong people glorify thee. The city of the terrible nations shall fear thee. For thou hast been a strength to the poor, a strength to the needy in his distress, a refuge from the storm, a shadow from the heat, when the blast of the terrible ones is as a storm against the wall. Thou shalt bring down the noise of strangers, as the heat in a dry place, even the heat with the shadow of a cloud. The branch of the terrible ones shall be brought low.
Yes!
And in this mountain shall the Lord of hosts make unto all people a feast of fat things, a feast of wines on the lees, of fat things full of marrow, of wines on the lees well refined. And he will destroy in this mountain the face of the covering cast over all people, and the veil that is spread over all nations.
Yes.
He will swallow up death in victory.
Yes.
And the Lord God will wipe away tears from off all faces.
Yes.
And the rebuke of his people shall he take away from off all the earth.
Amen.
For the Lord hath spoken it.
Amen.
And it shall be said in that day, Lo, this is our God. We have waited for him, and he will save us.
Amen.
This is the Lord. We have waited for him. We will be glad and rejoice in his salvation. For in this mountain shall the hand of the Lord rest. And Moab shall be trodden down under him, even as straw is trodden down for the dunghill. And he shall spread forth his hands in the midst of them, as he that swimmeth spreadeth forth his hands to swim. And he shall bring down their pride together with the spoils of their hands.
Yes.
And the fortress of the high fort of thy walls shall he bring down, lay low, and bring to the ground, even to the dust.
Awesome. I hope that encourages you. It sure encourages me. Did y'all see all the miracles? Y'all understand Chinati and Kill Devil Hills and all these, all the things that he's had me do. Grand Junction with the shipping containers on the corner of Casimir and Rainbow, and those shipping containers going to a place called the Ark, and you know, just the whole thing, and the building, the Ark turning to light, and the whole thing. The building was made of a bunch of 2x4s that said T-Rex with two triangles coming together, making the X. I didn't buy the building. Jim did. And that was all the Lord. Everything that's happened has been the Lord. It's crazy. Anyway, yep, guys, it looks like our time is very, very, very close. Bear Hug cult leader, Jonathan Kleck, you're the bear. I'm the Bear Hug cult leader. I'm going to give you a big bear hug. Peace and grace from God our Father and our Lord Jesus Christ. Guys, I love you in Christ. Keep my friend Jack Lim in your prayers tonight. Just keep him in your prayers. I love you guys. All right, guys, here we go. Looks like our time is imminent. Let me take a quick look at the folder just real quick, because there's so much more stuff, you guys. I don't want to just keep y'all here. Let me just show you this real quick. The Royal Enfield. Isn't that crazy? He told me, I want you to get this. I didn't want to get the motorcycle. I was like, Lord, I really don't want a motorcycle right now. He told me, get it. I want you to take it with you. And it was my support ride so I could get out of the desert. Isn't it crazy? A Royal Enfield with a crown on it. And it represents us. I mean, can you imagine that my cabin right there had this big star on it, and my cabin had been split in half? All those river rocks, and this guy, the guy Danny, told me, yeah, this company came out and put big metal brackets on the corners and cables, and they cinched the building together and lifted it off the ground and then poured a rock foundation and set it back down on a rock foundation. Do y'all know how crazy that is? That's insane. That's all the Lord. So the Lord has done all these things, guys. All of them. Yeah, how fascinating. Isn't that just amazing? All right, I'm exhausted. I love you guys. I'm going to take 2 days off. I got to give my eyes a chance to recover. And I've got stuff that we're working on. We have DVD stuff we got to get going, and just other stuff, and I'm just overloaded. So y'all go check out the last four folders. Go look at the links. Blow your mind. All right. Now remember, there's stuff in the folders that a lot of it I can't get to you guys. There's just too much data. If you want to just freak out and see more stuff, just go to the folders, because there's just no way I can give all the stuff to you all the time. It's just too much. It's an overload. I got too much. Have you ever heard of too much supernatural data? That's so crazy. It's like, ah. All right. Peace and grace. One more time. You're the bear. I'm the bear hug cult leader, Jonathan Kleck. Big bear hug from Johnny. I'll see you guys at the party. It's coming. All right. Peace and grace. Guys, before I close, I want to show you one more scripture. I mentioned it in the other videos, but I want you guys to make sure you just write this on your heart. Go read all these scriptures and go open your Bibles and look at them yourselves in Esword. But this, look at this scripture, Job 11:6, and that he, so it's talking about God. For thou hast said, my doctrine is pure and I am clean in thine eyes. But oh, that God, that's Eloah, by the way. Eloah is emphatically from Hebrew 4:10, which is El, the Almighty God. It's singular of Elohim, but that Eloah would speak and open his lips against thee, and that he would show thee the secrets of wisdom, that they are double to that which is. Okay, without me like breaking down one single word, look at what it says. That he would show thee the secrets of wisdom, that they are double to that which is. I mean, do you understand what you're looking at? Look at the word that he would show. Look at the show. To stand boldly opposite. Why do you think the virgin's a dead sheep? Because female energy kills the sheep. To stand boldly opposite, to manifest, to announce, like Jonathan Kleck does a lot, always by word of mouth, to one present, specifically to expose, predict, explain, praise, declare, denounce, messenger, report, show forth, that he would show the secrets, a secret thing, a thing that is hid. To veil from sight, because there's a veil over everyone's mind that is concealed, literally or figuratively, to blind. Okay, remember, I've come to open the eyes of the blind. That he would show thee the secrets of wisdom, wisdom, skillful, wit, wise, to be wise, to teach that they are duplicate. They are double. Oh my God. To fold together to that which is. Now look at this. That they are double to that which is. Now watch this. It means twofold. Okay, so, and I want you to see this scripture right here, Luke 11:34. So the light, don't forget, Jesus is the light of the world. So his, that one eye, you know, the eye that goes to heaven, when you get converted and your other eye gets, you know, gets turned up, your eyes are folded together. And so that's so important that you see these words. Look at this. The light of the body is the eye, and therefore when thine eye is single, the whole body is full of light. Look at what this means. It means properly folded together. That is figuratively clear and single. So let me go to Luke 11:34 and highlight that for you. And then I'll leave you with that tonight. I love you guys. Look at this. Luke 11:34, you guys, isn't this cool? Look at this. So the light, the illuminator, the lamp. Oh, isn't that fascinating? Look at this. It says white. That's why they hate whites now. They hate whites. It's Luke. Lukos means white. So the light of the body is the eye. The eye. Okay, from the eye. And if thine eye is single, look at this. Here it is. Folded together as a particle of union. I'm going to highlight that bright blue. Folded together. Look at it. So if thine eye is folded together, thine whole body is full of light. Too bright to be full of light. To make shine or to make manifest. There it is. Okay, so I just wanted to add that. I'd already stopped the video and started rendering it, but I heard in my spirit, show them those two scriptures. So Job 11 and then also Luke 11. The scriptures bared it all out, guys. All the images I show you are confirming witnesses to the Word of God. That's how you know. It's a done deal. All right. I love you in Christ. Peace and grace.